Hi, my name is Simon Howard and I'm a solution architect at Micro Focus. So this video is all about security policies and how you use them in Fortify on Demand. So what you see in front of you right now is the Your Applications view for a demo tenant that I'm using today. And in this view, you can see a subset of the applications and their status for the tenant. So right now I know that there's an application called WebGoat 5.0, and this application has been statically scanned. And I know that there are a number of issues. We group issues into four buckets: critical, high, medium, and low. I know, for example, there are 613 critical issues. I also know, at a glance, that this application has failed the security policy that was applied to this application. I also know that it has a one-star rating. So what is the star rating, or sometimes called the assessment rating? Let's go look at the definition in the Fortify on Demand user's guide. So here is the section that applies. The section is called the five-star assessment rating, as you can see, and I've highlighted the key points about what defines these star ratings. So a one-star rating for a scan means that there were some critical level issues found. There may well have been some high, medium, and low issues as well, but the important point is there were some critical level issues. A two-star rating means that no critical issues were found, but of course, there's still some high, medium, and low issues. A three-star rating means that no high or critical issues were found, but there could still be some medium and high. In fact, there will be. A four-star rating means that no medium, high, or critical issues were found, but of course, there were some low-level issues. And finally, a five-star rating means that absolutely no issues were found at all. So it's nice and straightforward. So let's go back now to the tenant. And now let's talk about what a security policy. Well, what is it? So we know, again, looking at this application here, the WebGoat 5.0 application, it has failed. Let's go click on that. So we're going into another view now where we're going to look at the various scans that have been performed for this application. We'll go look at maybe the scan for version 7.0. If I click on this, I can see details of a security policy that applies to this application. So I know that it's using the business criticality high security policy, and that policy says that in order for the application to pass, it must have had at least three stars. And we already know what the star rating is. Now we know what three star means. Now, if we go back and look at the application, we can see that it's got issues in all of the security levels in actual fact. So we absolutely can see that it doesn't have a star rating of three. We can see it actually has a star rating of one. So clearly it's failed the security policy. What defines that? So I can go look at the settings for this application. If I click on that, those lines there, I can see there's a settings for this application. And I can see that this application, WebGoat 5.0, has an attribute defined for it called business criticality, and it's set to high. So what does that mean? So when you create an application or edit the settings for an application, you can define or edit, if you like, the criticality that applies to that app. What does that mean? So your apps are of various levels of importance to your business. If your app is of high business criticality, that will probably mean that if there's something wrong from a security point of view for that application, it's a big issue, right? Conversely, at the low level side, if an application is of low business criticality, if there are some security issues or maybe functional issues for that matter in the application, it doesn't matter so much. You've got a bit of breathing space before you need to fix those issues. You decide what the criticality is for an application. Okay, so we're going to leave the criticality of this application as high, and I'm going to go back to where we were. So we know this application, WebGoat 5.0, is high business criticality, and I could change the criticality if I wanted to. I didn't do that right there. So what defines the security policy and how are they used? So let's go look in the administration view. In the administration view, I'm going to bring up this window again, and I'm going to select policy management. Now in this policy management view, I have two tabs, policy assignment and policies. Now, we know that the WebGoat application we looked at was using a security policy of business criticality high. We actually also know that it was high business criticality. So there's the mapping. So basically, the app is of high business criticality, which means, as defined in this view here, that it's going to use a security policy called business criticality high. Now you can actually change what's called the scope and how the policies are mapped to your applications. And to do that, you can click Edit Scope. And right now we're using business criticality, but we could group applications and policies together using either application type or attribute. If I just select application attribute, for example, I can use one of these, a set of attributes that are available to me. Now, I'm going to stick to what we have, which is business criticality. That's what we're going to use to group applications together and apply policies in this tenant. What I can do is create a new security policy. To do that, I go to the Policies tab. Right now, I'm seeing the policies available on this tenant, and I can create a new one really easily. But just to recap first, here is the business criticality high policy, and it has a star rating of at least 3. That's required in order for an application to pass that policy. Let's go create a new one. So we're going to call this something like, let's think, that we'll call it new business criticality high. I didn't spell that correctly, so we'll just change that. There we go. And we'll keep it as a 3-star rating of 3. We'll keep the policy such that the default, which is no application monitoring is required, but we will change the compliance requirement. So by default, an application has to have passed all vulnerability. We're going to use all vulnerability categories, I should say, in its assessment of whether it's passed or failed. But I'm going to change that and just say, actually, for applications using this policy, I'm only interested in the OWASP 2017 security requirements, if you like. Then I'm going to click Next. And in this part of the wizard, I can define the types of assessments that can be performed for the applications that use this security policy. I'm going to keep it at allow all assessment types, but I could, if I wanted to, just limit an application so that only static assessments can be performed. That'd be very easy to do here. I'll click Next. Now I have 3 different stages in the this wizard, if you like, where I can define various things that apply to applications in the development, QA test, or production states in the development lifecycle. So, for example, for applications that are in the development state, I could say I'm going to allow a grace period if there are any critical level issues. So right now it's set to 0, but what I could do, I could say if some critical level issues are found in a scan, I'm going to allow you 7 days from that scan in order to fix those issues before I mark that that application as failing that particular aspect of the security policy. I'm actually going to keep it as 0. Also, I can enforce a policy which says, for this application that follows this policy, you must conduct a static scan at least every 2 days, let's say. Again, I'm going to keep it as it was at 0. So I can enforce how frequent a scan needs to be done, whether it be static, dynamic, or a mobile scan, if it applies. I'm going to click Next. Same thing for QA test, applications in the QA test state, same for production, and then I click Next. I can see a summary of what I've stated in this policy, and remember I can change this later if I get something wrong, of course, or change my mind. I click Save, And now the policy has been created. There it is there. If I go back to the policy assignment tab, now what I can do, of course, I can basically, for this drop down here, for the high business critical applications, I can select that drop down and I can change it to new business criticality high. I'm not going to change that, but that's what I could do. It's very easy to do it. I would change that. In fact, I will do that actually, just prove that point. And I could click save, and that would save it, obviously, but I'm not going to save it. So we'll go back to what it was. There it is. Okay, so one final thing. Let's go back to the applications view and look what else you can do with security policies. So on the right-hand side, you might notice I have a star rating attribute. And what I can do is straight away see across my tenant how many applications have basically got, in this case, a 1, 2, or 5 star rating. There are some applications that don't have a star rating, and that's because those applications are not in a production state. Okay, that's how you use security policies. I'll see you in the next video.